The House of Haller presents Tales of the House of Haller.
DT's West End Tickler, read by Chris Courtenay.
Solossys. The late 1970s were a somewhat literary time for me. I'd just written my first teleplay and combined reading for the London outposts of Hollywood film companies with a part-time job at Solossys newsagents in Charing Cross Road. Although it would be hard for some people to imagine a time before the internet, such days did exist once. And in those far-off, sepia-toned days, Solossys was Google to actors in London, because we had the stage, and more importantly, the stage job ads before anyone else. And even if you were established and in regular work, you still wanted to see what was out there. I remember my chagrin on being told that the elderly lady I'd just served was Ingrid Bergman. One regular was theatre manager Geoffrey Wren, who came in for his Daily Mirror. Geoffrey gave me my first ever comp for a show at the Criterion, devised and produced by a young man who, Geoffrey felt, would go far. The show was called Tomfoolery, and I ended up working for that young man, Cameron McIntosh, for 24 years. So it goes.